everyone, and welcome back to Dungeons Divided Rivenheim. We're happy to see you, excited to see you as always. Excuse me, I've had a lot of LaCroix. Welcome here to lovely Float Studios in beautiful Los Angeles. This episode is sponsored by our sponsors, +32 Charisma and The Goods Merchant. Before we get into anything else, let's introduce you to these amazing heroes. First, a quick note, Shauna is unable to make it this weekend. We look forward to having her back at the table as well. Missy DW. And let's introduce, starting there at the bottom left, Mr. Roy.
Hello, I'm Roy Halo. I don't know why I just did that, but I did!
Take my shit.
Yes, thank you. I did. And I will be playing Corin, the Rogue.
And hello, everyone. I'm Solar Gray, the Cinematic Sorcerer, coming at you from Float Studios. We're like balloons here. And since everyone's coughing a little bit, I will be playing Cytherial, the Elven Shadow Sorcerer.
Ooh.
We're not sick, I swear.
Okay, hi, I'm Chris Rickabaugh, and I will be playing Aldor Rothgate, the personality disorder? No, he's just got issues.
Hi, everybody, I'm Zoe, I go by ZozyPose on the internet, and I am playing my halfling monk, Paya, who may, at some point in this campaign, make some paella.
At least you're not a strawberry. Hi, I'm Joshua Story. I'll be playing Zolger, the Goliath fighter. Hope you guys are doing well tonight. I'm ready to bash some skulls and get into it. So I'm going to throw it right back to the DM.
Thank you so much. My name is PJ. I am the DM for this awesome game with these awesome players. And we're going to get into today's episode after this beautiful introduction. Hope you enjoy. See you soon. Welcome to the show. If you haven't had a chance already, please make sure to like and comment and subscribe, hit the bell, follow us on our YouTube, and of course follow us on Twitch. Now, it is with great excitement that I get to introduce to you the official team name, the official team, the Unpredictables.
That's us.
Didn't see that coming.
Surprise.
That was...
yeah. And... If you haven't seen why they're called the Unpredictables, I'm getting way too excited, and that's hard to say when you're excited. Go check out our YouTube episode with that exact episode, but if you haven't seen it yet, see it after this one.
And it will show you a magic trick.
Yeah, it's a very magic trick.
No spoilers.
Right.
It was either that or sandwich. So I like sandwich.
I personally like sandwich, but I like the Unpredictables.
It's just a dumb name.
You know, if you stood by it, we would have been like, yeah, maybe, yeah.
Yeah, but the way that I pitched it was like, sandwich.
No confidence.
There's no confidence.
Listen, I think paella would have been cool. Do you like paella?
Love it.
Paella would have been delicious.
Oh, I love a good paella. So, well, yeah, we're waiting so long.
Let us open scenes with a nice, slow zoom in on the Unpredictables. And much to their name, I need to kind of... Audience, I don't know what we have nicknamed our audience members yet.
The Dictables?
No.
Oh!
I was gonna call you. I was gonna call them like Rivenheads, but that sounds awful.
I like the Dundees, but that's just me.
The Dundees.
Yeah.
Well, see, that just goes into a D's Nuts joke too easily. Anyway, let's refocus. Last episode, I was handed a very interesting note, and we resolved that a little behind my GM board. But I want to start off with that note now, just because I think it should be rather interesting. So it starts off with an exchange of a silver coin, crossing hands, and then a note comes back to Cetherial as the celebration is ongoing. The note seems to be attached to a piece of parchment paper, small, about enough to hold in your hand. And the note says, "I don't know why you need it, but I'm happy to take your money for it. Enjoy. I bet it smells funny too."
Ha. Ha ha.
And in the middle of the party, you have this package arrived for you. Like I said, a little wrapped paper the size of my hand.
So, I unwrap it, and let's say I sleight of hand it into my pocket. Or I sleight of hand the contents into my pocket.
Okay, so loud music, uproarious laughter, people asking for your stories. How did you get to be number two on the indie chart already? Lots of new runners curious to hear the stories. Lots of old runners looking to share, you know, across the table. My question is, does anyone try to clock this, or will this go on uncontested? I see a big smile on Zolger's face. Okay.
So there I was, and I had him in my biceps. He was held on the ground, and I was putting my face and head right in there, and he wasn't prepared. His knee almost gave out and buckled, and then there was this monstrous scream as it echoed throughout the chamber, and he was terrified of these gargantuan muscles.
And he just starts rambling on.
Rambling.
And because of that,
yeah,
the only reason I would be looking at Cytherial is because I'm rolling my eyes so hard. So yeah, I'm looking in your direction.
Another coffee!
I wouldn't have been. Yeah. Similarly to that, Paya's looking at the rest of the party to be like, okay, are we rolling with the bull? Or are we gonna correct him? Or what's the vibe you guys are thinking? So she might also clock.
Okay.
What's going on.
So, Cytherial, give me a sleight of hand check.
Seventeen.
You now have your number to beat. Perception or insight? I'll allow perception or insight.
No, 14.
Hmm.
I do not.
16.
You said 17? You can see he put something in his pocket, but it's nothing else, just a hand in the pocket.
Just more concerned with, come on, commiserate with me over this.
And Cytherial, deadpan, looks looks over at Aldor. And he winks. Zolgar.
Yeah, what can I do for you?
As regaling as your tale is,
yeah.
Since you are learning magic, I would like to show you something.
Ooh, what's that?
And I, sleight of hand again. However, as a distractionary tactic, since we are going to be taking a long rest, I cast a small bit of darkness in my hand.
Ooh.
I put it in the other hand.
Uh-huh.
And I put the contents of my left hand in my right hand.
Uh-huh.
And then I reach to his face.
Ooh.
I pull it back, and I dispel the darkness. got your nose.
It's not fair! Give it back! I need that!
When you learn more magic, and he puts it in his pocket, and he walks away. Every sorcerer knows this one.
It's almost as good as my disappearing thumb trick! Almost.
Do you want your nose back?
Yeah, I kinda need it.
You want it back?
I need it.
She's just gonna cup his face. And kinda like bap him. Be like, okay. You're fixed.
This is sure. Are you sure it worked?
Well, can you smell? What do you smell?
Horrible.
What do you smell?
The putrid stench of this whole bar. It is back.
It is kind of smelly.
That was a good spell.
Yeah.
I got to learn it. Anyway, where'd that coffee go? Coffee boy, where are yous?
Someone working for them, like, basically brings you another stein filled with coffee. I have to ask, though, is this the coffee that the establishment puts on, or are you sending out for the good stuff across the street?
I just told him big coffee.
So you are getting big, big cold. When I say cold brew, I don't mean that it was cold brewed. I mean it was brewed earlier today, and now it's cold. And they're giving it to you.
The jitters just won't stop.
The jitters won't stop. Ah, yes.
Can't tell if it's excitement, the coffee, or just good company. Probably the coffee.
So, if anyone wants to, you can make a medicine check, briefly as the magic trick comes to an end.
To see if the nose is still there.
Yes. Well, the other nose, actually.
Right. We already figured that out. Mm-hmm.
That's cute. I rolled a 10.
I wanted blackjack.
21?
Nice.
Okay.
Nice. Ooh. That's a nat one.
Okay.
You did not let it back in.
So, yeah, as he has shown you, you all see a nose. And you know it can't be Zulgur's nose, because clearly it never left his face. What you recognize with a 21 is that this is actually a mummy's nose, a mummified ancient creature. Now, that being said, I want to take the camera and turn it away for just a second. Corin, where are you going to?
As the festivities are happening, I slipped up and took the moment to go back to the library to speak to Cornac before it closes down.
Korak, excellent.
Korak, sorry, I should say.
Korak is reading something. Big book, and next to him is a massive stein of beer. It's like halfway done, and he reaches over, sees you, and he goes,
"Oh, yeah, good show, old boy. Welcome to the Relic Runners Guild. Miss, celebrations to you."
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Yes.
I forgive me, but I do have another question I wanted to ask you, and it was. Well, a bit private.
Of course, but don't ask too many questions. It's getting really good in this book. They're finally taking clothes off.
Oh. What's the book?
Oh, it's Smut, my dear boy.
Oh. Right. Well, of course not. I'll make it quick then.
Twilight, making dusk.
It's my question for you.
Yeah.
He will whisper to him, and he said, "The Syndicate."
The Syndicate? No, I've never heard of the Syndicate before. Never, the Syndicate? No. Mm-mm. Can't say that I have.
Right. He'll take a deep breath and look at him again. And can I roll for? I'm gonna roll for. I want to see if he's lying or not.
Oh yeah, insight check. Right ahead.
Insight.
Because
yeah.
He's never heard of the Syndicate.
The Syndicate.
The Syndicate.
My Genesis. No, sorry.
Okay, insight check. Okay, that would be a 21.
21. You get the feeling the only reason why he's being so loud is because he's genuinely never heard the Syndicate.
Okay.
Doesn't know better.
Got it. So you'll take out a folded piece of paper, and you'll open it up, and it's the drawing of the relic that he's looking for. It's a gem of a gem or a stone, I would say, and he will show it to him, and he will ask him, "Have you ever heard of the Moonstone?"
He hears that. He takes off his glasses, picks up the bookmark, and goes,
"Wait for it."
Yes.
They're making out. All right, let's talk about this.
How have I
ever seen that stone before? Hold on, let me just take out my device. Bring it to me, please. A little closer.
Of course.
A little closer.
Of course.
A little closer.
Of course.
Too close, dazzling light. That's a ruse. Of course I've seen it, you silly goon. I love moonstones. They're quite rare. How did I say? Very rare indeed.
Well, this one is one of a kind.
One of a kind?
Yes. And I'm looking for it. Do you think you would have seen something like this pass through here? How? Would I be...
Let me look at that again.
Yes, of course.
He puts it down. He starts casting a spell. And then, after a quick gesture and a snap... You see a magical image of the stone pop up in front of him. You're seeing information just piling up in arcane sigils, and like the two orcs kind of like slowly look at it.
Oh.
Oh, yes. You are quite correct. Ooh. There are many moonstones, but this is the
moonstone, yes?
Yes.
Yes. I've not seen this in town, but if it's in town, it'll probably be in the black market underground, or it could be in one of the many magical establishments, if it's been resold already.
I'm getting the feeling that it might be here. And he'll take out his charm. This stone is... excuse me. Excuse me. Frog in my throat. The magic is stopping me. This stone is attuned to it. It has not had any activity for some time, and recently...
Yes.
It started blinking.
Is it broken?
I mean, that's the intention, that is that it would be blinking if I...
I mean, it's...
Yes,
it's not broken all the time.
That's true, and it is... blinking an odd color. Normally, it just lights up, and now it's just lighting up a different color, and I'm not quite sure exactly what's wrong with it.
No, take a big breath, my dear boy. Take a big breath and breathe.
Yes.
Let me see this stone. Give it to old Karak. Let me take a look at it.
It's a matter of life and death.
All the more reason to let me look at it. What would you gain by not letting me look at it?
Of course, of course. Please.
Thank you, dear boy.
Puts on his little glasses and looks at it. Starts casting a spell. There's another pop. And another big screen pops up. And you see the two orcs in going,
"Oh no! That looks really bad!"
Bad?
Yeah.
Why?
This looks awful. Oh, yes. Oh, my. Look. It says here, it's been corrupted. Oh,
He was corrupted by a demonic spirit from the... Oh. My boy, did you say you were being hunted?
He'll bite his lip. Yes.
Yes.
And show him.
I remember a lot of things. I remember you now.
Yes, of course.
You see, all this information here. This stone is meant to be a connection of yourself and another self. Or something like that, yes. And as you see here, look right here. Right here with these letters up. Nowhere else, right here.
Uh-huh.
It's been invaded by a third party.
You're saying it's being manipulated?
No. Yes, I think someone, the person who is hunting you, mocked you, if you will, has a chunk of your soul enough to do it. So part of you is corrupting the stone. Part of him is corrupting you.
So it's worthless. I can't track the moonstone until I kill the nemesis.
Well, I mean, you could, but it would not. I don't think it would be very good. Wouldn't be very easy.
So he's mocking me. Great. Well, that makes sense. All right. Well, thank you.
Yes, of course.
That book on Nemesis, is that... that's the only one you have, yes?
Him specifically, yes. With the way the domains work, any matter or creature can come and go at any moment in time. And, of course, ancient beings as that. We don't have all the history still from the first world.
Has anyone ever survived being marked?
Most of them seem to die. The question, my dear boy, is whose terms do you die on? And do you have a really good backup plan? Death tends to stick.
Do you know where I can get a resurrection spell?
No. If I had one, I would be asking Amelia out on dates. She's like, I like to call her the praying mantis.
Right. Well, thank you for your help, Cormac. I appreciate it.
My pleasure, dear boy. Please, enjoy the festivities. From what I've heard, you've more than earned it.
Yes, well, I'll do my best.
Oh, and while you're down there, can you tell them to give me my fifth cup? It's getting really good.
Go ahead and do that.
Cheers!
Cheers. So he'll go ahead and take his stuff and pocket everything. Put his hood up. Make his way down slowly. Slowly.
And back to the party you stumble. Now, out of curiosity, what has this gentleman missed? What have each of you done in this party that's over the top, outlandish, and downright not civilized? What are we doing? I got the botchery on lock. What you got, my man?
So I'm down here and I'm sitting over the edge and leaning over Amelia. And I'm just like, so, you know, you make things go boom, yeah. Large and explosives and how'd you do that? Tell us.
You ask her how she does it?
He's basically flirting with her.
Okay. You know what? Give me a...
Oh, God.
Give me a performance check, and I'm going to make her do an insight check to see if she's picking up what you're putting down.
Speaking of the praying mantis.
Right.
Nice. It'd be a 15.
15, okay. Well, Diathea's of her role was a little higher than that. And as you start coming on to her,
the drunker she gets.
Yeah, she turns to you with her, like, 6-foot stiletto platform boots. And
she's stiletto now.
Yeah.
I know.
Oh, just stilts.
No, of course.
She's not partying.
Oh, okay. Yeah, that's fair.
Yeah, she put on her stilt boots. Yeah. So she looks to you and she sips a drink and she says, I can't believe I'm about to say this out loud.
Yeah, bring it on.
I can make a lot of things go boom. The question is, are you a coward?
No cowardy.
Good. First things first, I'm going to put a packet of black powder right in your sternum. Once your ribs are busted open, I'm going to jump in there like a raccoon. I'm just going to go to town.
That's what you just got enough. You just do your thing.
Okay, fade to black? Where are we taking this?
Message.
We need
life! Casting message.
Dude, he starts foaming at the mouth because it's too much coffee. He's just so fucking jittery.
Right into Zorger's mind.
Oh, you want to see this for yourself, do you?
You hear in your head.
Yeah.
Zorger. She just wants your organs. She signed for them.
Yes, she does.
She's going to kill you.
Yeah, what?
No. Really kill you. And collect your kidneys. You'll be dead.
I need those.
Yes.
What if I get hers first? Just say.
He stopped, and at this point, he's just like.
So,
Cytherial looks over at Aldor. Can I stop holding his beer yet?
Ooh. More coffee.
He goes to grab the beer. Starts down in that.
Give me a constitution check with disadvantage. You've had a lot of coffee.
Oh no.
No, that's 25 on the first one.
Oh shoot. Oh. Nice. Great. You're
with
my
disadvantage. That's
you're my
right.
Constitution
okay.
guy.
Okay. Yeah. Oh, okay. I'm sorry. That's a 22.
22. Okay. You're in that weird phase where the coffee is making you manic, but then the beer kicks in, you're dehydrated, but now you're just kind of leveled, almost enlightened. Everything is peaceful, but your body is numb.
Seeing glowy things.
Your stomach is so mad at you right now for having this much coffee and this much beer.
Uh-oh.
It's not a good time.
And but the porcelain shall be chipped.
But at least you're not, like, on the ground. You're standing upright, you're still in control of yourself.
Aldor, help!
Okay.
Remember that time you drank that coffee?
It's right over there, come on. Come on, walk, follow me.
I'm coming.
Waddle if you have to.
Yeah.
Oh, okay, it's 10 more steps. You're gonna make it.
I can't count it, I.
It's not that many. You'll make it. I believe in you.
Right.
Just kidding. Just run off to the bathroom. Okay. Does he make it? He makes it. I'm not gonna make you roll for that. You make it. We're all adults here. I'm not gonna make you crap your bridges. Pia, what are you doing?
Yeah, you have to roll. It's
debatable.
Your
you have to roll. That's debatable.
I guess this whole time she's been caught up in the celebration. She comes from a big family of sorts, really loves to celebrate, and she's in her cups.
Love it.
Yeah.
Okay.
She's feeding off of the energy of everybody who's been like, whoa, yeah, you're new, like, want a drink, want a shot. She's like, yeah, actually.
The music is dancing, the people are hearing your stories. At this point, I'm going to say, unless you want to make a con saving throw. Do you want to make a con saving throw?
Yeah,
see how drunk?
Absolutely.
Give me a con saving throw.
What's drinking if you can't make a constitution saving throw?
True.
Mm-hmm.
All
right.
It's all about the luck. See? All about the lucky charm.
21.
There you go,
okay.
Okay. So yeah, I'll say you're feeling good and warm. You're in the right party space. You're still aware of yourself. I'm having a good time. Not doing anything too embarrassing yet.
We've just become the anti-Wheaton.
The anti-Wheaton? Okay, I don't know. What wins? Will Wheaton's D20 or that lucky tattoo? We have to have a match and see who wins.
I think I've got the answer.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay, cool. So you're drunk, but you're not a mess. Do you have any things in mind with this state of inebriation?
I want to see what food they're serving. what's everybody eating? She's gonna get in everybody's business and be like, what are you eating? What's the best thing you've ever had being here at the guild? I need to know. I'm doing my research.
You see, like, this young relic runner goes like, well, it's, to quote my team captain, I don't know what it is, but it's hot and brown and plenty of it.
Oh.
We think it's a stew.
It's foul.
No, I feel good when I eat it. I gain 5 pounds of muscle eating this stew and working in that reliquary.
I lost 10.
That's because you did something else.
And it's hot and brown, and there's plenty of it.
And that's all you eat.
Oh, only when I'm here. Oh, and a few hunks of bread. Sometimes they make these really great cornmeal or cornbread muffins with like honey glaze on top. It's to die for when cornbread night comes around. You gotta fight to get a cornbread.
Do they put corn in the cornbread? This is an important question.
I'm afraid to ask. I've never been back to the kitchen. I don't know.
Where is the kitchen?
So we get the drinks from over there. Uh-huh. I've been seeing people take food out, and he points to this location, like deeper in behind the counter, uh-huh. where they get like all the ale, and deeper down you can assume there's like a kitchen staff there. Uh-huh. Yeah.
So I think she's gonna like clock out of the conversation with him and just immediately start going to where he was pointing.
And just like me, he's like, yeah, cornbread night is really just. Okay, Jeffrey, next one. Yeah. Ooh. And he just goes off.
Oh, Jeffrey.
Sorry, Jeffrey. Oh,
my dude.
Talk to someone else, Jeffrey. It's okay.
Just gonna keep trying.
We could do it, Jeffrey. We'll meet her one day. Or him. So you go sneaking off into the kitchen.
Who's in there? What's in there?
In there right now, you see Dahlia is a mess trying to run around and make sure everyone's... It's kind of like the bear, except like in fantasy world. Mm-hmm. And you can just see it's stressful. Everything's hot and sticky. And there's a giant bubbling crude in a big old bucket. And the bread's just being like kicked out of the oven like the minute it's done, just to feed these goobers.
Does it seem like the owl bear?
It's the owl bear.
Oh my god.
That's happening now. I'm making a note.
That's so good. So organized chaos, or do they seem like they have it under control?
They seem like they do, but there's not much control. It's like panic, anxiety, and speed.
I see. Yeah. Okay. They've had a little bit too much coffee.
It's going around, yeah.
Dahlia.
Hi. Yes. Hi. Good to see you. Hi.
Hi. Question. Burning question, actually, if you have a moment. Do you put corn in your cornbread? It's important.
Life
or death.
We use a corn mash, and then we add a lot of flour and other things to it to kind of bulk it up some, yeah.
But kernels?
No, we buy, I think, meal from the market in mass because it's cheap.
Can I work in your kitchen? Make some improvements, help out. You helped me when I...
Yes, I remember, and that was a hard day.
I would love to help you. You seem like you're having a hard day.
I would love to, but, you know, as someone who does a lot of work around here, the operator of this establishment, this is part of my domain. I don't want to just give it up without a fight.
I don't want to take over your domain. I would just like to help you with your domain. In your domain, it's... What do I do? It's honestly the only thing that I'm good at.
I mean, you're still alive, so at least you're good at two things.
Yeah, well, I mean, the reason we stayed alive was because of my cooking.
Do you have a sample?
Not at the moment. We kind of ate everything that I made.
I'll tell you what. I have stew, bread, and ale. If you can make something with those three ingredients that impresses me, take my kitchen.
Meat in the stew? Is there meat in the stew?
Probably.
Well, there's meat in the stew.
Meat.
There's probably meat in the stew.
Is it Dead Adventurer?
No. I mean, if it's Amelia, it has anything to say with it.
You said meat, ale, and bread. Okay. Yeah. Okay. She is going to take some of the meat out of the stew, and she's going to kind of cook it down with the ale. She's going to add the ale. She's going to take some of the spices, some very red spices. She's bringing out some very red spices that she's putting in there. She's going to chop up some, do they have any onions, kind of accoutrements, anything like that?
You're going to get cornmeal, flour, and not from your pouch, only black pepper.
Black pepper. Okay. She's going to take the bread and she's going to start like rolling it out a little bit.
Pia carries the special white powder.
She does not use the MSG.
To make stuff good.
She's gonna roll those out a little bit. And then she's gonna start cutting them into circles. She's cutting the bread into circles. Essentially, she's making like poor man's tortillas. If you've been there, you've had to make bread into tortillas at some point of your life.
The struggle.
The struggle bus, you know, she does that. And essentially what she's making, the meat from the stew, she seasoned it with a lot of paprika and chili powder and onion powder. And she's essentially made like a poor man's taco.
Hit like and subscribe if you're hungry now.
For more pie recipes, just read at Dungeon Divided.
Because in my family, we always add beer to our taco meat, and it's just so good.
Is it extra fats, extra sugars, helps it cook well? Mm-hmm. Okay.
Give me
your choice of skill to represent the execution of this cooking talent.
Okay. I'll go for medicine because she's using herbs.
I'll take it.
All right. Oh, come on! It went from a nat 20 to an 8. But that's okay. 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14.
14? Okay, she takes the struggle taco, bites into it, thinks about it.
Shakes the top of your head.
Just what I have. And I haven't been to the store yet. I need to replenish my herbs and things.
So you can do better. They can do better with more.
God, yes. Spirit of peace, yes.
I'll tell you what. 1 week trial. After that, anything I say is final. And if we keep going there, maybe we can talk about spice list and other menu items.
Yes.
Okay.
Uh-huh.
You make 3 meals a day for approximately 300 people. Do you think you can do that?
Yeah.
Joseph. Okay, good. Your first day's... Oh, God, we're going to have to do cleanup tonight. Your first day is tomorrow morning. You're going to be on cleaning duties, and you're going to start getting breakfast ready, okay? The staff will listen to you.
Well, I mean, I'm assuming the staff likes little treats, so, you know. The more they listen, the more little treats
you
they
keep
get.
This up, they're going to throw me out of my own house.
They're
going to
throw you out of... You will also get little treats.
Better be damn good treats. Tomorrow morning, first day. Don't disappoint me.
First day. Don't disappoint you. I won't.
Now what are you doing? Go to the party. It's for you.
I mean, Listen, I was excited about food. That's my thing. She's gonna
awkwardly
shuffle out.
It's freshly baked biscuits and various pieces of chocolate.
Yes. And the camera hangs on her. She just looks like, is that kind of like you know, stereotypical, like, that girl's going someplace. You know, that kind of vibe. Aldor, what is Aldor doing at the party besides?
Besides parenting.
Yeah, a little bit. Yeah.
He will seek out the more veteran adventurers and try to talk to them.
Yeah, they're definitely giving you the best table, the best seat at the table, I should say, the minute you pop up. Like, the new guy. I heard, by the way, about your contract. Very good deal. If we ever need help, can we call upon you for renegotiation time?
I mean, my services can be acquired, sure.
Great. Acquired, huh? By asking politely or what?
Well, politeness will get you pretty far.
Free, boys, he said free. You heard
him. I know what I said. I said pretty far. Trust me, it'll be worth it.
All right, then fine. Keep your secrets. We'll talk more when the day comes.
But for now...
Yeah?
Could we, discuss the reliquary?
Oh, I love it. Whenever I get angry, I've had a really bad day, I just go down there and there's always a creature to fight. I just kill it. And when I'm getting broke because I've been spending all my money, I just go down there. There's always a new trinket or bauble or artifact to sell. I sell it. I've gotten 5 magical rings of invisibility. I keep losing the damn things.
Because they're invisible?
Yeah, that's my punchline. Yeah, because they're invisible.
I'm picking up what you're putting down.
I like you. This guy's a good guy.
So, where do you spend most of your time?
Oh, man, when I'm not here with these guys, I'm probably working one of my other jobs at the other guilds. I work at the Bodyguard Guild for some extra cash. Sometimes I go to the Gladiator Guild. Non-lethal, of course. I'm too pretty to die. Yeah, and if I have a lot of money, a lot of free time, I go to the Gambling Guild. I go to the other play halls, and I just waste all my time.
But I mean, specifically, in the Reliquary.
Oh, in the Reliquary where I kill... Oh, I'm sorry.
Where do you, spend most of your time down there?
I'm called a first floor guy, or a oneer, or all kinds of weird nicknames we give ourselves for only staying on their first floor. I like it. It doesn't change too much. There's always something worth my time. Is it gonna get big payouts? No. But I can run in, run out, run in, run out.
Hmm. I see.
Yeah.
So you've met the Bone Jarl?
You know, I don't think I met the Bone Jarl. I found a few undead guys, killed them a bunch, but I've not met a Bone Jarl.
Oh, he's very nice.
Oh, is he? Now, I heard a rumor, is it true, that you killed old Brandi?
Well, I mean, I had a hand in it. It was a group effort.
Ah, I hear that he killed old Brandi. First day down there and you're making a name for yourself, killing the unkillable. So what was he like?
He smelled bad.
I remember that, boys. Yeah, next time you smell something terrible, it's not John's guts, it's old Brandi.
And he seemed really hungry for flesh. He just wanted to eat us.
Okay.
But, I mean, he didn't even touch me.
Oh, okay. Mr. Too Good to Be Touched by a Troll. All right.
I mean, our loud friend who... had to exit for a bit. Zolger, he's the one that did the final blow.
Ah, now I heard a rumor. Is it true that when you kill Brandi, he puts a little bit of the fire in his eye and yours?
I mean, I think so.
Huh.
I don't get too close to Zolger. I mean, maybe. Yeah, check it out for yourself.
Oh, I got to. I guess I gotta go kill old Brandi then. So listen, is there anything else I can do to help you? Like, you're gonna work for free one day, I should give something in exchange in return.
Well, can you tell me anything about down there, even further in? Any rumors, interesting things?
Let's see if I heard a good rumor from down below. I did hear one. Whenever you hear a song being played, get out of the darkness right away.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Is it like a certain kind of song?
I don't know. I've never been down there. I've heard a bunch of vets that go deeper talk about the song and the darkness, and whenever they hear it, they run out like little children. Yeah.
Also, is there anything we should be worried about with the people who flipped that table?
I didn't get a good look at them. I don't know. Why? What do they look like?
I described the adventuring groups who seemed kind of pissed.
Okay. Oh. Interesting. That sounds like that one... There's this group that got here a couple days ago, maybe? Mm-hmm. Got some new runners off the road, and they've been working really hard. Almost as hard as y'all have been. In fact, before you came down and put on the board, they were number 2.
Oh.
According to... the big talk of the leader of the table, they were in talks to becoming a corporate sponsor by Rivenheim Horizon Trading Company, the number 1 on the corporate leaderboard. Had a lot of things going for them, and then you all showed up, and well, you shat in their cereal really fast.
Huh. Aldor, just casually looks at the board. Who's number 3?
Number 3 under you?
Yeah.
Let's see if it's in my notes, and if it's not, we're going to go with something.
Should be who the old number 2 was, right? Blackmore.
Yeah.
Okay, that's on the corporate. That's corporate. This is the
indie. Oh, this is the indie. Okay.
Yeah. So the ones that used to be on the second position is Rald's Hunters. R-O-A-L-D-S.
I see.
Awkward though, right? We chase the leaderboard every day. Think you're gonna get somewhere, and the next thing you know, it's taken from you.
I mean, is there lots of infighting? Should we expect any trouble?
Oh, trouble? Yeah, no, absolutely, you're cooked. But as far as infighting is concerned, I don't know, we've only had a couple of death rallies.
I'm sorry, a what?
Oh,
a
death rally is what we call it. They have competitive runs where two teams go to get the same thing, but sometimes when they're down there, the teams don't play fair. And one team doesn't come back. But no one can prove what happened. Oh, we can all point the finger all day, but people die down there all the time.
And that happens sort of often?
Oh, gosh. Let's see. I've been here for a couple little while. I'm going to say I've seen maybe 3 death rallies in my time. I heard about maybe like things like 10 in the history. Yep. Real ugly down there, especially on the competitive runs.
Right. Okay. Also, have you gone past the Golden Gate?
Nah. I don't want to go in there.
Why not?
Kidding me? The stuff you have to give up to enter that door? Nah, I'm not that desperate.
Give up?
Oh, when you see there's a giant door there, it asks you to give up something. Something personal, something, you know, alive. And then...
Oh, it's sick.
Yeah. Dude, the first world sucked. I'm glad it's dead. This is a nightmare if it brought us here. But, I mean, hey. I got a pretty bitchin' job.
That's true. He keeps checking on everybody.
Well, with that, if you don't mind, I just want to jump into his ethereals. Yes. Especially since he's got a mummified nose on him.
Yeah, what the... Shit.
Well, he's enjoying the party. And he goes to a dark corner and just kind of stares at it. He contemplates booping the snoot of whatever was in the darkness.
Handle animal? Animal handling check to boop the snoot of the darkness?
I'm booping the darkness. I'm booping the darkness.
Love it.
14.
Reach into the shadowy corner. You reach in that little centimeter between rays of light, that realm between realms of the darkness. You reach out. You can feel something. And then you feel in your very essence.
Do it again.
Does
it poop back?
Do you see you pooping it again?
He said to do it again. And then I give a little scritch scritch.
You just... Do it again.
Soon. You can come with me if you like.
I would like that very much.
And Cytherial turns around and pats the back of his thigh twice. And he goes to find Aldor.
So you feel a presence, but you know that this presence is just a mirror. It doesn't exist in this realm just yet, but you can feel a large, fuzzy, brick-headed presence near you.
I think I'll call you Mouse. And I look for Aldor.
Aldor is in the middle of a uproarious conversation, and if you all don't mind, I'd like to put our friend Corin back in the game as well. Corin, you come down to this clusterfuck of fun time.
Yep. Yeah, Corin decides to join the party. He will walk up to the bar, mm-hmm. and he will ask them, yes, Korak asked if it can have something, the strongest drink you have. Something off the top shelf.
They kind of look to each other. Smut. Okay, hold on. And they go and they come back with a big stein, poof, and they slide it over, and they go, Dwarven Stout, he'll be gone before he gets to the end.
Thank you.
Have a good night.
And as he's, I walk away, mm-hmm. and I'm looking for my friends, I'm going to join the party. And I take a nice, big chug.
Of the smut stout?
Yes.
Okay, give me a constitution saving throw. Join the party, let's get a little drunk. We here at Dungeons Divided do not condone underage drinking or drinking beyond your limits. Please do so responsibly.
Yes. That is going to be amazing. Okay, so that will be a 9.
Woo! No. Well, they
drink responsibly.
Drink responsibly. Roll better.
Not like that.
Yeah. They weren't kidding. This Dwarven Stout is strong, and it's not helping you that it's in a very big glass. You start drinking this, and before you know it, you're not just warm and buzzed and feeling yourself. You're like lily hammered. You're good and gone, my man.
I just needed to feel a little bit numb. Just a little bit.
Right, where is everyone? We have a lot to party, we have a lot to celebrate.
Oh no.
And I will be looking for everyone.
Hooray! We...
Okay, alright.
And around this time, Sethereal, you are talking to Aldor, and Corin is blasted.
Alright, cheers. Oh, Zolgar! Hey. You wanna see a magic trick?
Yay.
No, he doesn't.
Yeah, yeah.
No.
Wait.
Yes.
Watch. What do you do? And
he grabs
a blade will appear in his hand.
I was gonna say, Zolgar grabs your head to steady you.
The nose.
And then he'll just slowly make it look like he's pushing it up his nose. And then another blade will come out of his ear.
We're about to lose a party member.
Oh, almost did it. He almost did it. I never saw a more that genuine self-controlled state of fear.
So behind the curtain.
Yeah, tell us the tale, please.
Behind the curtain. I really wanted to just grab that knife and then go, let me try. But restraint is always a good thing.
Yes, a little bit of resistance.
I thought he was going to grab it and do it to himself.
Yeah. Like, I was going to do it for him. Like,
No. Hey, that's amazing. That's amazing.
Yeah. Who wants to hear the tale of how Zolgar slave the brown eye!
It's brand.
How are you? Brown eye!
Yeah!
Yeah! Sorry, did you. Well
you this
came
is,
over for a reason.
This is apropos of what I wanted to discuss with you.
Really?
Yes.
Well, go on then.
Well, it seems you're not the only person here who changes the way they speak from time to time. I was wondering why that was.
Why do I?
Well, given the size of the container that Corin is holding, I assume that's his inspiration. But during our negotiations, you seem to be playing a sort of character? I do not understand.
Maybe we should go off in the corner.
Oh. What say you, Mouse? I think that would be prudent.
Who's Mouse?
He seems to be a shadow companion.
Yeah, okay. Well, you, me, and Mouse. Off in the corner, then. We sit down, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
So it seems that in this state of which you speak to me now, you seem nervous. A little anxious, one would say. But when negotiating, one would say boisterous.
I don't like talking that voice around other people very much. It's how I spoke at home. This is me. It's how I really am.
And this is the voice that you use when you're comfortable?
Yes. But I haven't seen any family in quite some time.
I understand that grief. I really do.
Also, the other voice makes people feel at ease around me.
Also, I understand. That is why I use this affect.
So you have another side to your personality?
If I were to unmask, I would sound like this. This is my genuine face. But when I'm around other people, I understand that I can be off-putting. So, I play this character.
I see. Or rather, I don't. As I do not see much difference.
The performance is subtle.
I see, and what does Mouse think of this?
I've yet to ask him. We've only met tonight.
Do it again. Jeez!
What are you doing?
19.
He loves to boop the snoot.
Are you booping?
Yes.
It appears you're booping.
Yes.
I mean, and not to cast any judgment, but you boop with some great ability. Like a master booper.
Why would I feel judged or condemned?
I don't know. I didn't expect the boopiness. I'm impressed.
Well, I feel closer to you. I have to apologize for what you saw when you were within my shadows.
Your shadows? Could you explain that a bit?
Oh, yeah, that's so good.
It's amazing.
I'm sure. Well, when I was at the temple and I learned things of Ledger Domains, I also learned of different realms. A realm of fire, a realm of water.
I see.
But there you wouldn't.
The realm of shadow. I take it.
That's a name for.
What's your name for it?
Comfortable. Cozy, I think, would be the better word.
me explain a little something so you understand my reaction. My family disappeared. My parents. My brother went looking for them. And he came back not right. Seemingly possessed by some type of entity.
There seems to be a lot of that going around.
And it felt very similar to your shadows. And I may have overreacted. But I don't sleep very much.
I would assume not. We do drink an enormous amount of coffee.
Therein lies the rub. I mean, might as well drink the best.
Fair. I like the color.
I like the feeling. You first sip, and everything warms and spreads out in your body.
Like a thousand little fingers.
Yes, see? See, you understand.
It's how I feel there. But I still don't understand why the voice that you use at home seems more comfortable, and the one that you exemplify in company seems less so.
This one reminds me of home and my family. It's a double-edged sword. It makes me very comfortable and gives me confidence in dealings. But it also hurts.
At that,
immeasurably.
At that, the door slams open to the guild. Almost as if, like, the trigger of saying it hurts. Wham! You see marching with great purpose five different people. A dwarf, a half-elf. You can tell these are the Rald's runners, the Rald's hunters, the one that you've just recently usurped. The leader, a very confident and stocky dwarf, comes running in and he says, "All right. Where are these unpredictables? Where are they? Show them to me right now. Come on, I host parties for them. They gotta be here."
They are right here.
Do you want an autograph?
You would never guess where they would be standing.
Let's not be hasty.
Corn's on top of the table.
Yeah, he is.
Yeah, he is.
Cheering with everyone.
With half a pint this all took.
Takes, all right. Drinks it all down, yeah. Throws the mug down, jumps off the table.
Ooh, give me an acrobatics check with disadvantage. Sorry, man, you're very drunk
not
at this point.
Be hasty. Mean
can I provide help?
Yeah, he heard be hasty.
Yeah, he did.
You said acrobatics, right?
He did.
Oh, yeah.
Let's see. Let's do this.
No, we'll get to that. I want to see it. I want to see where this goes.
Oh my god.
How bad?
Yeah, that's a.
No, it's not bad at all, actually.
Oh, it's good.
With disadvantage, I had a nat 20 and a 19.
Oh, so,
holy crap!
Oh my god!
I don't know what's happening here. So that's 25.
Strong as a skunk, you freaking stick the landing. Oh my god!
You've got the edgelord drunken master.
Yeah, 100% drunken master.
Yeah, so I basically do like an aerial off the table and just kind of land. Right. They're right here. What do you want?
Impressive.
My name is Rald's from Rald's Hunters. We were second in place. We had a contract with the corporal on the line, and you took that from us. So we're gonna take it from you. Everyone, listen up.
We don't have a contract to take.
Yeah, Rald is officially challenging you lot to a competition run.
Oh, and let me guess, you plan on attacking us the second that you can.
No, thank you. We are with honor. We are angry, but we are with honor. We have to go to the dead room behind the Golden Gates. first person to grab the artifact and bring it back deserves the spot in second. But Al, they deserve the spot in first.
If
I may?
Yes, please.
If you're challenging us to such a perilous competition, why not simply go grab the thing behind the death gate yourself?
Probably move you up in the rankings.
I mean, it's not something that we would do willingly. And I assure you, we were not aiming for a high spot on the board this early in our career.
Give me a persuasion check.
That's true.
13.
Can't your problems.
Oh my god, you should boot it.
Just stop stepping on my punchlines.
What was your roll total?
13.
13. Okay. So you say that and he says, "Look, no one goes down there. But since we seem to have a problem for who's on second and I don't know who's on third, this will solve the problem immediately."
I think it's already decided.
No,
and it's us.
Decided.
We're number two.
And listen, if we get that artifact, we're number one. But good. If you get it, we quit the guild.
Doesn't number one have something to say about that?
No, because it's a point tally base. They'd have to get it. Unless you want to make this a three-way competitive run, we can challenge the All-Stars too.
We've still not agreed to
competing
with you.
I really just don't care.
You, I mean, yeah.
Hold up. We don't give a crap about number one or number two or number three. What's the point?
The point is that we lost an opportunity because you got lucky. And we want a chance to get our old spot back. And if you don't take this competition run, you're not going to look reliable for contractors. If you don't take this run, we're going to let everyone know that they can't trust you.
Well...
That makes no sense, actually.
You realize you're saying this in the middle of a party.
Yeah.
Like, you're admitting out loud to sabotaging us if we show maturity?
No, we're not going to... No, it's going to be...
You sound like babies, actually. Don't they sound kind of childish?
I mean, bartenders,
you have
something in a...
Sounds to me like a you problem.
If the bartender has something in a bottle, perhaps with a rubber top, that would be good for them.
Could we get a sippy cup?
So
five sippy cups.
As the rounds of birds just heap upon this dwarf with great vigor, you.
I walk up, I storm up right behind him, down to his level. He's a dwarf.
Mm-hmm.
Come down to his level, all the way down. And I say, "So, you want to race?" And he's just jittering.
And he looks at you and goes, "In 2 days' time, we will race. You have 2 days to prepare."
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
I have a better idea.
What's that?
How about the first person who kills Nemesis? I'll challenge you to that!
Oh, look,
that's
man,
sick.
I...
Oh, what?
He's
got a real problem. I don't feel so good anymore about challenging you. He's gonna die. He's dead, you know that, right?
I'm sorry, I think he's had a bit too much to drink.
but no, Zulgar. You recognize someone in the group. Bath Elf. Long ears, kind of like Rabbit. Manic face. He's avoiding eye contact with you real hard.
I'm sorry, I was coughing. Did you say bath salts?
Bath salts?
You two look familiar.
Talking to the FO?
Yeah.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Don't I know you?
Yeah. Nah, man, I just got into town, like, the other day. I'm one of the new members of the team.
Can we tell if he's lying?
Yeah.
I reach out to grab a hold of his shirt.
Hey, man, this isn't cool. We're trying to challenge you to a fight, not a dance competition.
My hands, like, go from his shirt down his arms to his...
That's a good idea. A dance competition.
Okay. You know what? The grapple check. Make an athletics check. You're probably going to win, but still. Oh, no, that's not a good number.
Dirty 20.
Yeah, he's got a 16. So yeah, you can see him like, hey man, no, I just want a drink, man.
Does he have bracelets like mine were?
Or chafing?
Heavy metal gauntlets. Right here. Manacles.
Chain. Dink.
Broken.
You don't need these anymore. And I rip his arms off.
Oh, dear. What?
Give me an athletics check with disadvantage. So you go to rip his arms out.
Yes.
As you get that little bit of torque so you can do it, yeah. Slips him right out, shoves you off, and he goes, hey man, control your friend here, man, okay? I don't know him. And you know what? This is insane. I think he attacked me. We have the right.
Actually, you know, it's funny. You've got the same manacle things that he did.
What?
I think you do know him.
No, I live an alternative lifestyle, man.
I remember you, you coward.
What's his name, Zolger?
We were the running in that field.
Oh, no, I wasn't running in a field. Oh.
Oh, yeah, I remember.
Oh.
You abandoned us.
I wasn't in a field.
What?
I don't know you.
You know what? We accept your challenge.
We do?
Because you need to know, it wasn't luck that got us through that run.
Okay.
Hell yeah. It was skills. And then I'm like doing I start dancing full on, like, and then two knives come out and it's a whole freaking rave light show. You wanna have a dance competition? Yeah!
Not that competition.
I could have sworn it was luck.
The dwarf looks at you, Raoul looks at you, and he says, it ain't a dance competition. 2 days. We meet here at the same time. We leave at the same time.
Like 2 days.
They're giving up the dance competition, so we win the dance competition.
Was that enough said.
Egg on your face.
All right, fine. But as long as I win the competitive run,
but you're not going to. I mean, look, you're number three.
Don't you start
obviously, you're not gonna win.
That's a trigger for me. No. I'm gonna get so
mad. You triggered?
I'm a little pissy about it.
You know what? It's okay.
I'm gonna cry.
Oh, you're gonna cry about it?
Yeah.
I'm gonna cry for you.
2 days.
In 2 days, I'll show you a new magic trick.
I fail to see why you're so upset at us for doing well without trying.
Yeah, maybe if we tried.
We lost a contract. The challenge has been issued.
I mean, we kind of just walked through old Brandeye. Yeah.
Oh, the challenge has been issued. You agreed. 2 days' time. We meet here. We go down there together. First one back with the artifact wins.
What is the artifact? Do you know?
Come
back with something and be like, look, we got it.
You know what?
No, I don't. That's why I'm asking. I
mean, it's a giant thing in a room full of dead people. What do you want from me?
A giant thing.
I mean, how do we know that you won't just buy a magical artifact from someone else coming out of the reliquary and hide it and say that you won?
Or maybe you've got one in your trunk down there.
Yeah.
I mean, there's gotta be some rules.
Okay, fine. I'll tell you what. Mm-hmm. Tomorrow morning, over breakfast, we discuss the rules. And then...
Are you willing to do it naked?
What?
What?
I don't even know.
I mean, you're trying to compete with us to show who's the best. If you were so much better, then you should be able to do the same thing that we did with not nearly as much equipment. And we barely had anything.
True. I mean, Zolger didn't even have armor.
He didn't mean in your skivvies. He didn't mean that.
Okay, look, breakfast tomorrow. We discuss the details. And then after breakfast, 2 days, and we do the run.
So then 3 days.
In total, yes. God, okay. It's so hard to be a bully to people these days. God damn it.
Well, if you were a little better read, it wouldn't happen.
I tried my best. It was not easy. My dad was a blacksmith. He didn't make a lot of money. You know, I'm going to go home before I get more angry.
Sorry.
Maybe I could recommend
a book.
I
did not have much to read. Oh, boo and who.
All right, fine. What do you recommend I read?
Are you going to cry now?
No.
No, he's going to cry when he loses.
Okay. Hey, you shut up.
It's called My Little Displacer right Beast.
My Little Displacer Beast?
Yeah. It's delightful, and I think it would help.
Are you sure that's on his level? I mean, he could probably use Everyone Cries.
Well, maybe
I think
both.
His picture is on it.
So after the nonstop burn session you keep heaping upon this man, he goes to the door and he goes, breakfast! And then in 3 days, competition run!
Do you want a smiley
shut
face?
Up! And he storms out.
Just bacon for the vinegar. Smile.
Corin is, while this is happening, Corin's in the back and he's stripped down to his skivvies. So are we doing this?
No! What? Why?
They just forfeited.
Can you imagine if this party had a bard?
Maybe. Maybe the true bard is the whole party we met along the way.
We just collectively cast Vicious Mockery.
Yeah.
And you didn't have to make a save. It was eviscerate this guy.
Well, see, the thing is, it's make memes about him until he cries, and then make memes of him crying.
Tears. God, that's terrible.
It felt like that first episode of Letterkenny where the and they just get annihilated.
Oh yeah,
like darts off, boys. Like, oh, look at you, look like your happy trail leads to a mysterious treasure there, doesn't it?
Yeah, really.
Doesn't it, Big Shoots?
Yeah, doesn't it, Big Shoots? It's like, the one thing about like, oh, does that's a nice shirt. Does it come in men's? Oh, I think you come in men's enough for all of us. Anyway, let's back it up.
Stupid. So as they're going out, talking about breakfast, meeting at breakfast, what they said the next day?
Can we give a couple of seconds to make that easier for the editor?
You mean they don't want to see us just shooting the shit?
Aw, people don't like us for us.
Aw.
I'm not editing out any of that.
So as they're heading out, talking about like, see you at breakfast, yay, crying. Paya's gonna like pull everybody together and be like, hey, I got a great secret to tell you guys right now. Guess who's in charge of breakfast tomorrow?
No. You?
Yeah. And guess what they're going to be eating?
Oh no.
Poison?
Well, not. You're so dramatic. Wait, should they?
No. That's cheating. They're just.
Is it, though?
Well, they're just not going to get anything good, is what I'm saying.
Some blandness.
Yeah, but.
Oh, that's going to hurt. No,
but what
I
about
recommend,
us?
No, what do we blandness get? Is not something that she does.
Something good.
I recommend spice.
Oh, yeah, lots of spice.
Too much spice.
Too much spice.
So much spice.
All of the spice.
It'll be fine in 2 days. It won't affect the actual contest. It'll just be fun.
I wonder if I can hire an artist.
Wait.
Speaking of artists.
I think I need to puke.
Oh, no. What are you drinking?
Why are you naked?
All these questions and more to be answered. But before we do, as the door's about to swing closed one last time, one figure stops and looks in just one last time. Terror. Guilt. Fear. Jadak looks at you, knowing full well what happened just a few nights ago. As he looks at you, slowly turns away. Some words get caught in his chest.
Fuck you, man.
And he just leaves in the night. Solger, what's it like to see that ghost still alive?
I take my feast and I... as I look on in satisfaction, knowing I'm gonna get my revenge. And then I turn around and laugh with the rest of my group. Because that idiot over there drank more than I could.
Well, with that, with celebrations and threats, We end this episode together. Libations, celebrations, and threats. That's how we party.
Huzzah!
Huzzah!
Someone carry me to a bed.
Yeah.
You don't need any more.
We need a long rest. We've needed a long rest for so long.
For so long. Well, this will be a nice long rest, and we'll have that breakfast together next time on Dungeons Divided Rivenheim. We'll see you then, folks.
Bye-bye.
Good night, guys.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye.